at the small forward position, number 10, Lexi Hull. At the point guard position, number 17, Erica Wheeler. At the other forward position, number 1, Melissa Smith. The other guard, number 0, Kelsey Mitchell. Starting at center, number 7, Austin.
WNBA on 2K Sports. Moments away, it'll be the Minnesota Lynx going up against the Indiana Fever. This is Blake Suniga alongside Tim Swartz and Brian Vanifatemi, and we're excited for some 2K hoops. Well, coaching in this league, not easy by a long shot. What's the biggest challenge for head coaches?
Well, for me, there's only 12 teams in the entire league, so you see the same clubs quite a bit, coming up with different wrinkles, the game plan, and that's so tough to do. Everybody knows everybody in this league.
Yeah, and for me, it's the roster size. You only have 12, sometimes 11 players at your disposal, so you have to be smart with rest, you have to be smart with minutes, and you don't really want to overextend your stars.
Pass the hole. Mitchell. Now Smith. From 12 feet out, good on that jump shot.
There isn't a part of the court that Mitchell won't let it fly. When she hits from the mid-range, it just increases the headache for the D.
Collier with it. It's good, and she makes her first shot of the game.
Good passwork. The assist was right on target.
And just about a minute into this first quarter. Pass to Hull. Back to Mitchell. Laid in with a nice touch off the glass.
Nice ball movement from Hull. Terrific at recognizing when her teammates are open.
And here's McBride. It's stolen by Hull. Wheeler with it. And just around a minute and a half into this first quarter. Allen with the steal. And now the Lynx fast break. Up the floor. The lead pass was put in just the right spot to produce the layup. Let's take one more look at that great Mobile One drive.
Well, it's all about breaking the paint, whether it's creating for a teammate or for yourself. While the end of the last decade was pretty rough for Indiana, they were one of the best teams in the league from 2009 to 2015, making it to at least the Eastern Conference Finals in five of those seven seasons.
Allen, Miller. Here's Collier. Can't get it to fall, and she's missed her second after making her first. Here's Hull. And so she earns a trip to the line. Official saw the contact.
First personal foul, teams first.
Well, no question, Hull gives her all on the play, making the effort to get the contact and earn the whistle.
Going back a few years for the Fever, during that 2009 to 2015 run, they were one of the elite organizations in the league.
Absolutely, reaching three WNBA finals, including winning it all in 2012. I am sure that Fever fans are itching for those glory days again.
That free throw missing.
Well, a 3-and-D wing. Players like Lexi Hull, so valuable here in the WNBA.
And
she's good on the second.
Well, from the moment Lexi Hull was born, she's had someone right by her side, her twin sister, Lacey. Together, they won national championships in high school and then again in college.
Now here's Collier. No go. That's miss number two. She is one for three. Smith with it. Collier's there. Shot's good by Smith. And the Hull twins, known for their tenacious style of play.
Well, it's a big reason why Lexi went sixth overall in the 2022 draft. She leaves it all out there and works very hard defensively. And that's a mindset that started in the backyard playing against her twin sister.
Give an assist there, not for a pass, but for the solid screen set on the inside that freed her up and really just made that layup possible.
Now here's Mitchell.
Traffic and lays it in.
And we're approaching about 3.5 minutes played in this first quarter. Here's Allen. To the middle. Terrific assist and a nice finish. Just a solid play all around.
The plan worked perfectly that possession. Get it inside, get the high percentage shot.
Now here's Mitchell.
Trailing by two.
Pass to Wheeler.
And the layup's good off the glass.
Look how quick she was to bite on that pump fake. Left her feet way too soon.
Now here's Allen. She's tightly guarded. And here's Indiana. Outside Wheeler.
Going to count the bucket and send her to the line.
First person to foul. 3-point play.
On 4 years of college basketball, Erica Wheeler averaged just about 7 points per game. Undrafted out of school, Wheeler's game has translated really well to the WNBA.
Wheeler, her scoring average has gone up in the WNBA.
Well, she's also been top 10 in the league in assists. And really, some players like Wheeler, when they get to the pro game, they thrive because it's more of an open game and it's played at a quicker pace.
The Fever with the lead.
Tipped away. It's stolen by McBride. 14 feet out. And again, no good by Minnesota.
And it's the Fever ball. They get it again.
Here's Hull. That one off the back iron and out.
Man, they've been looking out of sync offensively.
They need a bucket in a big way here to regain some confidence.
Miller. The three-pointer is on target.
Three.
Indiana with the ball. Mitchell outside.
Pass to Smith.
Puts up a three.
He's now 2 for 3 with that miss.
They had some botched coverage that turned into no coverage.
And when she's open like that, you don't see her miss that sort of look very often.
Now here's Mitchell.
The bucket counts, and she's on her way to the line to try to make it a three-point play.
The all-time leader in college threes made. Kelsey Mitchell went second overall to Indiana back in the 2018 draft. Brought in as the future of the Fever.
And
Kelsey Mitchell, for years was the focal point of Indiana.
Yeah, and unfortunately for Kelsey, the Fever struggled, failing to make the playoffs each of her first several seasons. But Mitchell never complained, still put up numbers, and goes to show you the kind of professional she is.
Now here's Vivian's.
Shot's good by Cannon.
And look how well she met her in there with that pass.
Minnesota trailing. Down low.
Oh, the stupendous finish in traffic.
Unselfish basketball on the interior. That's the kind of pass a coach loves to see.
Indiana calls
time called here. The Fever decide to talk it over.
We'll talk about the dynasty day of the Minnesota Lynx. One of the keys to their great run in the 2010s, trading for Sylvia Fowles in 2015.
Indiana with the ball. 3-point lead. Pass to Wallace. The three is up. No good on that shot.
She had all the time in the world to get that shot off.
Miller. Easy jumper from very short distance.
During her time with Minnesota, Sylvia Fowles won every award.
Yeah, MVP, Finals MVP, a couple Defensive Player of the Year trophies. What didn't she win? But of course, most importantly, it was multiple championships. That 2015 trade sending Fowles to Minnesota, it changed the history of the league.
Just five to shoot. Indiana again missing. They've been trailing for a few minutes.
But that could change right here.
Here's Banham. And that misses. That would have put them up.
Now Wallace.
Good for the basket. Wallace. Starting off one for one with that shot.
Fantastic pass. She made that a very easy bucket with the setup.
Good. She scores. That's her first basket after missing her first two attempts. One for three. Here's Banham. No scoring yet from her, but that's likely to change. To the paint. Parked down low that time and got hit with the 3-second call.
Indiana ball.
And here's Indiana. It's a 5-point game.
Pass to Egbo.
Now here's Vivian's. And we're going to have a jump ball. It's tied up there.
That's a jump ball.
And here are the Lynx now. And here are the Lynx now. Poked loose. 7-second difference between the shot clock and the game clock.
And here's Cannon.
Shot from 12. Off the left rim and out.
Being that close to the hoop, I thought she had enough room to nail that one.
Here's Banham. Good on the triple.
Rachel Banham.
Here is Vivian's. And the Lynx pushing it up now. Here's Carlton. Can't tie it up as that one's
that's
no good.
The first quarter.
A good close contest so far as we finish the first quarter.
21.
The Fever on top. They're up by two. And back in a moment as we'll get underway with quarter two. Getting underway, no team gaining an edge so far. And what stands out to you from the Fever in this one?
I like what we're seeing for them going right at the basket. Tons of points down there in the paint.
They've been the aggressor early, attacking the hoop and getting in the paint.
Pass to hole.
McBride covering.
Shot clock at six. That shot off the mark. And Minnesota the other way now.
Now Carlton. Hole defending.
And the Indiana shot counts. She's fouled. That's a chance for a
first
personal
foul. Teams first.
It seems like every single year the league is setting records for three-point shots attempted. You guys think we're at the peak of that, or is there still room for more?
I think so. I mean, teams have gotten much better defending the three-point line, and I think there's value to that mid-range shot. Teams can't possibly take more threes, can they, Tim?
Yeah, Brian, you know, I don't know. I mean, a three-point shot is absolutely here to stay. It allows more spacing out on the floor, so maybe we'll see teams take even more threes.
Falls, and that puts them up. It's a one-point game now.
Now that we're a couple years out of the 2010s, one thing is very clear. The Minnesota Lynx were the team of the decade.
Now here's Wheeler.
Here's Cannon.
Here's Hull. And good work on the boards, and they pick up the second chance points.
Well, taking full advantage of her length, Lexi Hull gets the rebound and makes the second chance play work.
Pass to Collier. Carlton. Reverses. And she sinks the layup.
You see, some players will try to overpower you at the rim, but she likes to elude you and trick you. She's got quickness and a soft touch.
Now here's Hull.
McBride covering. Off target from outside.
The Lynx dominated the last decade, winning four championships.
Six finals appearances in total. And remember, before winning the lottery and getting the number one pick in 2011, Minnesota had missed six straight playoffs. So sometimes to turn that franchise around, you just need a little bit of luck.
It's stolen by Hull. They're moving it up. It's stolen.
Now Carlton.
Count it.
Bridget
first
Carlton.
Second make in four
assist
attempts.
Two. Number 14.
Wheeler with it. Pass to Hull.
Up from the top of the key.
Kept alive. Cannon.
And she drops in the layup off glass.
Not enough bodies on the glass right there, and they paid for it.
And it'll happen again and again if they don't put more effort into boxing out.
And that's what it's all about, Brian. Rebound. Effort.
Now a timeout called by Minnesota.
Well, basketball is life in the state of Indiana, from high school to college to pro. They just love the game at every level in the Hoosier State.
Both teams will make substitutions. Now here's Allen. Collier, covered by Smith. Collier inside. Smith is there. And the basket by Collier. Playing in basketball-crazed Indiana, the Fever have a great following, and you'd expect nothing less.
Yeah, for sure. These fans are awesome. They're loud, and they really know the game. Indianapolis has to be one of the best stops in the entire league.
The score now all even.
Well, Wheeler's three ball has come a long way, and her improvement also helps her team's spacing.
Pass to Engstler.
Takes the three. The Fever pull it in. Now here's Wheeler.
She's covered by Allen.
It's stolen by McBride. And now the Lynx fast break. Here's Engstler. And it's good. Caught through the contact, hit the
first
shot, and she'll go to the line.
You know, Emily Engstler does a little bit of everything for this team. She's a double-double threat, but she can also chip in with steals and blocks.
Today's WNBA, teams really want players like Emily Engstler.
And that's why Indiana made her a top five pick. Engstler has great size, can shoot. You can really play her anywhere from the two to the four. Just a flexible player.
Now here's Mitchell. She has seven. Five to shoot. Back to Smith. Over Collier. And that one goes long. The Lynx leading. Here's Allen. The three. No basket with that shot. Having trouble finding the range. She is one for five. Low block shot. Sinks that one from the post.
On offense, her team will take that all day. Melissa Smith, a skilled finisher on the inside.
On the wing, Kayla McBride. Mitchell, right side, over McBride. A shot by Mitchell, no good.
Good D there to get a hand up and force the miss.
A perfect example of why she has such a strong reputation defensively.
And the Lynx miss again.
Well, she rushed that one. The D was out of position, but she couldn't make them pay.
And that puts them in the lead.
Very nice feed by Mitchell there. She's a team-oriented player who enjoys setting the table for open teammates.
And that was the mobile one drive, low resistance to the finish line.
Just tremendous intensity going downhill on that drive. Love the attack mentality in a close game.
Now here's Allen. Engstler. The three-pointer, no good. Outside Wheeler. And Erica Wheeler gets double teamed. And another three for Indiana.
Have to admire just how selfless Erica Wheeler is. She loves finding her teammates in their sweet spots.
Now a timeout called by Minnesota. And the WNBA free agency has become much more important over the last few years.
Yeah, Blake, you take Candace Parker's move from L.A. to Chicago. She signed with the Sky in 2021, and Candace was key in Chicago winning their first ever WNBA championship. We are seeing, over the last couple years, as you said, more impact signings.
And that's great for the league because the offseason has just become so interesting. And I like to see star players getting to choose where they go. It makes the league really exciting.
That's good by Smith.
Such a high motor player, Melissa Smith, relentless on the boards.
Right outside. To halt the run. It's hauled in by Smith. The Fever leading.
Ball's knocked loose.
Mitchell covered by Collier.
To the inside.
Egbo.
And they pick up two.
That pass led her so perfectly, she didn't even have to break stride.
Here's Bannum. It's good for her second make. Two for three so far.
Hard to get that shot off with the size difference there. That makes it a tough individual matchup for her, especially down low in the post.
That's a big challenge she's taken on. Going in there with the bigs, great job.
Now here's Mitchell. She has seven. Pass to Smith. That one falls, coming off Kelsey Mitchell's feed.
And I want you to think about Smith's positioning on the play, setting the screen right where it needs to be before rolling to the shot.
Here's McBride, covered by Vivian. McBride misses.
You can tell she thought that triple was going to fall.
She's just shaking her head after that miss.
Here's Egbo. Victoria Vivian's on the wing. And she can't extend the lead to double digits. The Lynx trailing.
And they could use a big shot here to get this offense going.
Yeah, too many empty possessions. It's simple. They need points.
The catalyst of the team, McBride, is dependent on for buckets. And I'll tell you, she usually delivers.
Outside, Vivian's.
The official whistle of foul on the shot. The bucket's good, and go to the line.
Number 34, one shot.
While joining as an expansion team in 2000, the Indiana Fever have one title. That was in 2012 when the Fever defeated Minnesota in four games, bringing Indy their first WNBA or NBA championship.
Check out that assist. That's a pair of teammates on the same page.
Outside, Vivian's. Pass to Egbo.
Side. Mitchell, shot's good.
What a tough player. Lots of times, Mitchell is the smallest player on the floor, but her heart might be the biggest.
Now, 5 seconds separating the shot clock and the game clock.
And here's Milic.
Lays it in without an inch of room around her.
Now here's Mitchell.
She's guarded closely. Off target with the free throw line, Jay. Here's McBride. Got it off in time, but it's no good. And we finished one half of play. The Fever on top, leading by 7. And we'll be back for the second half following the break. Keep it right here on 2K Sports.
Just a pile of assists for her,
which isn't a very common occurrence for her. You know, typically she's more of a finisher, but that's just not the case in this one.
And here's Cole. That's tipped
and stolen by Kayla McBride. Good for the fifth time and 5 shots. She remains perfect.
Understanding defense is better than most. McBride's a playmaker with an advanced feel for the game.
Woo! Outstanding dribble drive. And that replay was brought to you by Mobile One.
And in a tight one like this, you gotta dig deep, find a way to make things happen.
And that one drops for us.
She's up to her usual trick, shooting it well, scoring a lot of points, getting them in front.
And stolen by Smith.
Yo, watch her. The 8-footer. The shot comes out. And Minnesota the other way now. Here in this third quarter, just over a minute played. McBride misses.
On the wing, Kelsey Mitchell.
Pass to Wheeler.
basket drops, and she gets fouled on the shot.
First personal foul, team's first.
Well, Wheeler was just undeniable on that play. Pushes past the foul for an and-one opportunity.
And this is her second trip to the line in the game.
Drafted out of college, Erica Wheeler has carved herself quite a career in the WNBA, beating all the odds to get to this point.
Now here's Allen. Collier, covered by Smith.
Shot, left block. Connects, the jumper drops. Now here's Wheeler.
And Anafisa Collier led the league in minutes during each of her first two seasons in the league. I mean, pretty much unheard of for a rookie, for a young player. That type of D, it's just not going to cut it. They got to get a hand in her face. Too good of a shooter.
It's good, and she drew the contact on the shot. So she'll go to the line.
First personal
3-point play opportunity.
And Collier, is this someone you can't afford to keep on the bench?
Well, Nafisa has such a diverse skill set. I mean, just look at 2020, when she ranked top three in steals and rebounding, top 10 in blocks and baskets made. I mean, you name it, and Collier can do it.
From 2011 to 2017, the Minnesota Lynx went on the best extended run in WNBA history, reaching the finals 6 of 7 seasons, winning 4 titles.
Wheeler, she's covered by Allen. Pass to Hole.
Over McBride. Rebound by the Lynx. And she uses the glass on the layup.
And the Lynx going on that incredible run. Brian, will we ever see a stretch like that again?
I really don't think so, Blake, because there's just so much parity in the league nowadays. And to me, that makes that Minnesota stretch even more impressive.
Now here's Mitchell. 12 points for her. Smith.
And the rebound paying off as they pick up 2 on the second chance bucket right there.
Minnesota trailing.
And that'll be Minnesota's ball as it goes out of bounds. Lynx able to keep the ball here. So both teams changing it up here. Clock keeps going. 3 minutes into the second half now. And that one goes in as she fouls. It'll be 3 points if she can convert the free throw.
Miller, one shot.
Wheeler, 9 points in the game.
Pass to Hole. Wheeler. Here's Wallace.
The basket good off the assist from Erica Wheeler.
You know, it doesn't have to be perfect. That pick wasn't all that effective, but it got her just enough room to get the shot off.
Now Engsler.
3-pointer. Can't hit that one.
Wheeler with it. Now guarded by Collier.
Pass to Wheeler. Clock at 6.
Smith outside.
Fades. The shot, no good. Now the Lynx take it the other way. Pushing it up. The 11-footer.
Alyssa Smith grabs the miss. to Wallace.
Now here's Wheeler.
Now here's Hole. She's guarded by Anxler.
Down low. And you can count it. She'll go to the line with a chance to make it three.
That pass into the paint was dead on target.
Well, it's really hard to pick the best Lynx team in their franchise history, but I think I have to say 2017. They led the league in offensive and defensive rating. They went 27-7, and oh yeah, by the way, they won a title.
And beyond the numbers for the 2017 Lynx, the roster was just unreal.
Oh, you look at that roster. I mean, you have multiple Hall of Famers, a defense anchored by Sylvia Fowles, one of the best defensive players ever, an offense that was efficient. That 2017 Minnesota team had it all. I think they're in the conversation for best WNBA team ever.
So the Lynx now,
trailing by 10. Pass to Carlton. Let's it go from deep. And again, no good by Minnesota.
Now here's Smith.
She's covered closely.
Here's Wheeler. Lexi Hole on the wing. Wallace.
Shot clock at 5. An amazing finish with a hand right in her face.
And here are the Lynx now. A 12-point game. Pass to Milic.
Uses the glass to finish the layup.
So it's Indiana now. And here's Cole. Now Wallace. Wheeler. She's covered by Allen. Now here's Hole.
6 to shoot. A strong finish under heavy pressure from the defense.
An excellent display of strength and concentration by Lexi Hole, hitting the shot through contact.
Diamond. Count it.
Miller.
Nice touch near the
assistant,
hoop.
Lindsey Allen.
Here's the Fever with the ball.
10-point lead.
Pass to Hole. Wallace. Hole up top.
Tries a 3.
Offensive rebound. Fever. Outside Wheeler.
Drills it from outside.
Well, how about Wheeler this time getting the feed? Ready to shoot off the pass. Normally, Eric is the one dropping dimes.
Here's Carlton.
Hole defending.
And Fever basket foul. Is good. Let's got it to go through the contact. Second so a free throw foul. Coming up. Opportunity for a 3-point play.
So it's both teams making substitutions here.
Free throw, no good. And it's the Fever ball from downtown.
Offensive board.
And another basket for Indiana.
Crash the boards with purpose right there. Some hard-earned second-chance points.
Allen guarded by Wheeler. And the Lynx miss again.
She can't get anything to drop. And the way she's going, it's probably not something to try to shoot her way out of.
And I'm sure her teammates would agree with that. You know, the last thing they want to see her doing is shooting.
Now a timeout called by Minnesota.
The coach needs to tell their players to box out with some energy. That's basic basketball. They've been lazy all night long. Too many second chance points.
So the Lynx now. They trail by 16.
To the middle.
Here's Milic.
Plays it up and in despite the excellent defense.
Wheeler with it. She's got 15.
it to go for bucket number 8. He's taken just 10 shots.
And really, guys, it's been an exceptional performance from her from the field.
And she was fouled in the act of shooting, an opportunity for a 3-point play.
That's a great job, really, to angle her body, shield the bigger player from the ball on her way to the basket.
And you have to know how to finish like that if you're going to take it down low. And she showed all the capabilities of doing so.
And that one misses. Glass.
Assisted by Emma Cannon.
And here's Banham. She has 7. Pass to Carlton. There's the triple. Good on the 3-point shot.
Nice offensive awareness to exploit that lack of coverage.
Now Cannon. Egbo. 5 on the clock. Another shot. And count it. 2 points with a chance for one more at the line.
Terrific job to convert the putback. She stayed with that play from start to finish. And that's something we say about her a lot.
And she's got her first opportunity at the line here tonight. To the teeth of the D and converts the layup. Trying to add a few more points to their lead.
And it's not rocket science at this point. Just stay with what you've been doing.
Now here's Vivian's. She's been patient so far. Nothing yet on the scoreboard. To the right side. Down to 5 on the shot clock. Bangs home the trifecta. Allen again.
Lindsay
Minnesota
Allen. The assist, Rachel Banham.
Knocked loose. Allen with the steal. Let's go with a 3 and a miss.
That's the end of the
and here's the end of the third quarter. It's a double digit ball game. A Fever on top, up by 15. We're going to step aside for just a second, but join us right back here for the start of quarter number 4 next. And it's time to bring up the State Farm assist of the game.
Well, this was some artistry right here. Great decision on where to go with the ball and a perfect delivery.
And they'd love to see every possession end this way, Tim. It's true team basketball.
It's just so much fun to watch.
And we're rolling here again with the fourth quarter. Might not come down to the wire, but you never know. To the wing on the left. From outside the arc. And the rebound goes to the Fever. Here's Egbo. That one goes.
Queen.
Counting.
Yeah, late reaction for the defense. She's always going to convert that.
And no lack of aggression on that move. And that's good enough for the 2K drive.
And even with the game well in control, they're still going right at the rim. You know, I love that mentality.
Now here's Allen. It's hauled in by Cannon.
The shot was there for her. She had to take it. And I don't care if she didn't convert. She should take it again next time.
Wheeler, good.
Chalk up a few more points for this. This has been a one-sided game in just every area.
Absolutely. Their defense, their offense, it's all been outstanding.
It's just been a tremendous performance, Brian.
It's good.
The defender a little hesitant to get in her way as she burst to the hoop. I'm not sure what was going on there.
Collier. Covered by Collier.
Here's Hull. Blanketed by the D. Points to the rim for the layup.
Everything they put up is falling in, and that score keeps climbing.
And that is one demoralized set of defenders out there.
And the basket by McBride.
Can score from anywhere on the court, and McBride has really taken on that alpha personality type.
They're running. And it goes as the official calls the foul. Count it, and she'll shoot one more at the line.
Kayla McBride is someone you can count on. She was a starter the moment she got into the league back in 2015, and she pretty much always averages double figures.
Well, and just a steady hand. Kayla McBride is the type of player coaches love.
Well, we know one thing. Coaches love free throw shooting, and McBride, just about a 90% average at the line over her career. One of the best marks in league history. Plus, McBride barely turns it over. Really, just an efficient player.
It drops. That's her ninth field goal of the contest. A blistering hot 9-for-11. Boston. Was fouled, and second he's going to the line foul. For one more.
Number 14, one shot.
Underestimate Collier's ability as a distributor. She'll make passes that make you say, wow.
Number 14, one shot.
A touch under 2.5 minutes have passed now here in the fourth. Time called here. The Fever decide to talk it over.
Well, they want to tinker with the game plan a little bit, and now's the time to do it.
Yeah, there was clearly some things going on out there that the coaching staff just wasn't a fan of.
Outside Wheeler. With a step back. No good there. Now the Lynx take it the other way. Collier outside. McBride launches it. It's hauled in by Wheeler. Mitchell outside. We're in the final quarter of play here, 3 minutes in. Six on the shot clock.
Hull
lets it go from 11. That one goes
Lexi.
In.
Well, we've seen Lexi Hull has some range, but she can also slash, bring it inside.
Now here's Allen.
Guarded by Wheeler. To the inside. If you're just tuning in, welcome. We've played about 3.5 minutes into the fourth quarter here.
Cannon, covered by Collier. Past a hole
from deep, and the Fever hit again.
Lexi,
a textbook feed to Hull, who was all set up, ready to shoot.
Out to the wing, from the arc, the Fever pull it in. Earlier, they held a 23-point lead.
Here's Cannon.
McBride covering. Victor Kleen. Here's Collier. And they're going to count the bucket and send her to the line.
Fourth personal foul.
3-point play. Misses.
After becoming the WNBA's Rookie of the Year in 2019, it's safe to say Nafisa Collier has a bright future in this league.
Now here's Hull. And stolen by Collier. Pass to Allen for three.
They grab their own miss.
And there's the basket. Whistle blows and a chance for the three-point play. Going to the line for one. Free throw, no good.
Well, Kayla McBride is a good free throw shooter. I mean, is there anything she can't do?
And there's the 3-second violation.
3 seconds. The ball goes to Minnesota.
Here's Allen. To the middle. Here's Collier. That falls. Nice feed that time from Lindsay Allen.
Uses every bit of her strength to overpower the defense. Collier does not fear contact.
Back to Wheeler. It's a deflection. On the wing, Kayla McBride. Hole defending. And the basket by McBride.
Operating with an awesome swagger and confidence, McBride has become must-watch television.
Now here's Mitchell. Back to Wheeler. Pass to Mitchell. That's her sixth make from the field. She's taken 9 shots and missed only 3.
She had her head on a swivel and was able to still pick out the pass and get the assist.
Here's McBride. Here's Allen. Off the mark there with the 3.
The defense has nothing to worry about out there with her shooting because she just can't dial it in for deep this afternoon.
That one, good for 2.
They've been able to depend on her offense all game, guys. She's just not wasting any chances, any shots she's had.
And if they want to make things even easier on themselves here late in the ball game, I got an idea. Just keep getting her the basketball.
Shot's good by Cannon.
Don't need much range to hit from that distance.
So the Lynx now. 17-point game. Out to the wing. Miller. And no good. Now Indiana takes it the other way. Up top, Wheeler.
He's covered by Allen.
Here's Kelsey Mitchell for 3. And another 3 for Indiana.
It has been a 3-point barrage for them since halftime.
Yeah, I don't know if it's been by design or by accident, but either way, it's been impressive.
Maybe the coach just went up to the locker room chalkboard and just put a number 3 out there.
And they've been really controlling this one.
Never want to get too complacent.
2 minutes remaining in the game. 2 minutes.
Back to Wheeler. A shot from the low post is good.
And with that basket, you have to think this lead is safe.
I don't know if I'd call it 100% secure, but at least 98%.
I'll go 99.2.
And here's Kayla McBride from the arc. It's hauled in by Wheeler.
Not quite enough defense that time around. Lucky she was off.
I just hope that was a mistake by the D, because if that's how they plan to guard her, they're going to have serious problems.
Now here's Hole. Pass to Wheeler.
It's good, and she drew the contact on the shot, so she'll go to the line. 3-point play opportunity.
Both teams deciding to change it up. And here are the Lynx now. Pass to Engsler. Mielich. Engsler with it.
Covered by Vivian's. Miller. Drills the three-pointer.
They're enjoying a commanding lead.
And you know the best part? It gives them an opportunity to give their starters a rest.
Yeah, they might not have to come back in.
Now here's Vivian's.
Pass to Egbo.
The tray.
That's no good. It's her second miss. She's made four.
Makes it off the glass.
Well, their offense has kicked into gear, but it's come just a little too late.
I think it may be, but at least they're finally showing some signs of life offensively, but too bad it's past the point where it'll do them much good.
Yeah, absolutely.
Now here's Vivian's.
Here's Saxon. Covered by Collier.
Just five on the clock. Free throw line jumper.
Rebound by the Lynx.
Miller. Guarded by Wheeler.
And that was good. Collier.
Oh, the high degree of difficulty make from Collier. What an adjustment in body control.
Got a piece of it.
So it's the Fever taking care of business in this one. They poured it on tonight. A dominant showing in front of the crowd. They love every minute of it.
This game really a defining game for what they can do when they're playing at their best. Being here at home helps, but the execution anywhere was terrific.
That'll do it for our broadcast, everyone.